Earlier in the year at the NAMM show in January, we launched the SL5. Now, funnily enough, Slash was the first person that we did a signature Marshall amp for in the mid-90s. We did the JCM Slash, which at the time was a reissue of the Silver Jubilee, which hadn't been in production for a while, and it was an amp that Slash really liked. So we rebadged it and made a few minor internal tweaks and called it the JCM Slash. He was the first person to have his signature on a Marshall amp other than Jim at that time. Since then, there's been many other signatures, and also a couple of years ago, we did something called the AFD-100 with Slash. Any of you guys heard of that amp? It's a very cool amp. It was made limited edition to recreate the sound of the Appetite for Destruction album, and generally his tone as well. From there, we figured why not do something smaller, because 100 watt heads aren't for everybody. So we've come up with this, which is the Marshall SL5. It's a 5 watt slash voiced amplifier. It's got two channels, very cool. You've got a clean channel and an overdrive channel. You don't have to be a fan of Slash to appreciate it. Here, there's built-in reverb. It was in tune when I bought it. It does switch from 5 watts to 1 watt, and what I meant to mention on the JTM there is it switches from 1 watt to 0.01 watts to make it even quieter on the rear panel. As I said, the Slash goes from 5 to 1. There's the clean channel, and then to give you an idea of the overdrive. So it's very, very cool, and obviously it does that Slash tone really well. And when we did the UK launch for this at the Birmingham Guitar Show, which was back in February, I compiled this next little track, which is also going to be my last. And this is Ode to Slash. Okay. thank you so much. That was the Marshall SL5.